So no, sits down. Me, Chris, and Gabe just in here chilling. We here. That fucking tree falls right beside the fence,
bro. Oh, shit. Did you know him?
Yeah,
bro, you saw the. Tell me you saw the video, right?
He showed it to me at work. So basically, the bitch kept getting closer into my face, into my personal space.
And I don't like that shit.
I missed the body catcher, slaughter gang, soul snatcher.
Katie, bring it in.
What age would you consider a sugar?
Imagine we had a Katie to bring it in.
Yeah. And now, the TYF podcast.
Welcome back to another episode of TYF Podcast. We got a special guest with us today.
Me, Lalo.
Gone brazy. I'm glad. Oh anyway. Yeah, guys, nothing but pure fucking vibes.
Mi líder. What's up, y'all? Still fucking tired.
His videos are funny and stuff. Mm. You've seen his video?
Oh, I got brazy?
Yeah, the one on Facebook.
Facebook?
Me líder.
Yeah.
Who says that? Who?
This is like dude that makes videos that says that.
Oh, the TikTok guy?
I guess.
He's Dominican?
Yeah, that's like, him on Facebook.
Wow!
He's yeah, like that? Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Who are you talking about?
I got it right here, bro.
You sent the video.
I've seen him.
I don't know.
I've seen him.
Somebody sent the video of me líder.
I think about him.
Shit, I'm gonna y'all just pointing fingers.
He was in the restroom saying he's going to sleep and everything. And then
yeah! He walks out of the nigga, you sent that! You fucking sent that, bro.
Where'd I send it through?
The group chat.
I guess.
No, that nigga has in a lot of videos.
But did y'all talk about DR on the podcast?
Last week, kind
of. Some of it.
Most of it.
Alright, well, first, let's get to Lalo.
We got a
me?
Guy. Yeah. That guy.
I don't know who the fuck that is.
Because last time we had Lalo.
Yeah.
It was
Lalo. Damn, 3A. What is it? 3-2? 3-2? Podcast? Or son más?
This would be the
three. Fuck.
Damn. Oh, yeah, we did have one with you and the guys here.
Hey, oh, what, last year?
Yeah. When was that, like 2 years ago? Hey, no way, 2 years ago. Nah.
Yeah, yeah.
2 years ago?
Time passes. What the fuck? Oh, time passes.
Elephant in the room, though. You got bigger.
You got bigger.
I got a beard now. Got a beard.
Hell yeah. He does got a beard now.
No, they didn't have that before.
Shit.
Yeah, secret, crazy. It's booty.
Oh, shit. Folks with it? Folks with it?
You gotta eat ass to get that?
No. Yeah.
To an extent.
To an extent.
How many days a week?
3 times a week?
Israel, I see that you shave yours.
So what? The bulking is that?
Still currently now. I'm almost 200 pounds now.
Huh?
Yeah, I'm almost 200 pounds.
But that was like always a plan, no? Bulk?
Yeah, bulk, yeah. I think 2 years ago I was probably like, maybe like 170?
Yeah.
170, now I'm like 195 almost in the morning, yeah. A lot of food though.
Still. So what does that consist of now? Like just eating a shitload?
Shitload, yeah.
Shitload of what though?
Sweet potatoes, ground beef, that's the secret.
For real?
Yeah.
That's how you gain weight?
Yeah.
When did you start seeing it, for real? Like, dang. Like, now I'm actually...
To be honest, like, 4 weeks ago. 4 weeks ago, I was probably like 180.
This nigga, 180.
180.
You gained 15 pounds.
180. I was sort of... I was like 180, 183 in the morning. And then I was like, fuck it. I'll just go back to sweet potatoes. Still chicken and rice, but sweet potatoes and ground beef. And I do that. I do 3 big meals. So I weigh my food. So I do 400 grams of sweet potatoes. So that's... almost 2 potatoes, full sweet potatoes. And
oh,
then
yeah.
It's damn. A lot of food, yeah. It's a lot of food, but...
Fuck
you. You still
yeah.
bag?
Fuck yeah, all the way.
You still bag?
All the way, bro. Oh, fuck. No. Bro, all the way, bro.
Bro, you gotta learn how to not gag.
My throat game is not strong, bro. Fuck. Can't.
Okay.
Can't take it, bro.
But damn. Hit me up with it now.
You like sweet potatoes?
Like, you like the sweet potatoes for real?
I do. It's weird. So I have a coach still. And then he makes me add honey. It's sweet, so but yeah. It still tastes really good with the ground beef and sweet potatoes and add honey.
Oh, so like you mash them together? And you
know, yeah, I mash them. So I do boil the sweet potatoes and then just cook the ground beef. And then I just weigh and then smash it after and then add honey a little bit. Just
you meal prep your own stuff?
Yes,
a meal prep. You ever bake them?
No, not yet.
Bro,
that's
you
too
bake
much.
Them?
I can't because it's easy to eat, so I just eat it. You know, I just have to eat them.
Do you
Sorry, never mind. Keep going. I'm just going.
Your mom's more important than me.
My mom likes to do them like así, like in the oven, and then she puts like, what's it called, lechera on them and shit. It should be fucking good.
So it's like kind of sweet a little bit more.
Yeah, with the, yeah, with like the lechera mug. And then some brown sugar or something on top of it. It's like a dessert. It's
my mom had cinnamon, so it's adds a little bit good, really good too. So,
do you eat a lot of fried food?
Fuck yeah, I still eat junk food.
Oh, okay.
I just eat like cheap meals during the weekend, you know. I still have a life.
What's like not eating a lot for me?
What do you mean? Like,
what's like a lot of food to you, or a lot of food to me, maybe not a lot to you.
Yeah.
So like, what's like a small amount that you eat a day?
My smallest meal is 7 eggs in the morning.
7 eggs?
That's my smallest
like
meal.
Like scrambled or?
Scrambled, yeah, scrambled.
Seven eggs,
yeah.
Max four, yeah.
I can't.
I be eating four. I'm like, damn, I'm eating too much.
No cap.
My girlfriend getting mad, but like, you're not supposed to eat that many eggs. Only like two or something.
Yeah.
Four, seven
eggs, yeah, in the morning. No, cook, fuck no. Can't.
So you go grocery shopping like?
Yeah, dude. Fuck. I went grocery shopping last Sunday. I bought 2 packs of ground beef that were $18. Think like probably like 10 pounds of sweet potatoes.
The 5 pound chub is what you get?
Yeah.
You should shop at Sam.
They're $9.85 this week at Super One.
But I bought 18.
Oh my god.
They were $18, bro. I was like, fuck.
No, this week they're
not. Can we not solicit on the pod? Please.
Guess how much for that? Just guess how much was that?
For
just
how much? For what?
For 2 packs of ground beef and then 10 pounds of sweet potatoes.
Like 60, 70?
They were $18.
70?
60, 65?
Yeah, I was going to say about 60.
So you're doing that, what, every like
every week? 3-4 days.
Dude, you should buy a
Sam's, yeah.
You should get a membership. It's probably.
I think my mom has it, so I might just use her car.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, never mind. Hell yeah, especially at Sam's, like, the more you get, it becomes more worth it the more you get.
Hell yeah. I don't even. My mom has one.
Sponsored by Sam's.
He's not soliciting on the pod.
That's sponsorship, though.
Oh my gosh.
Hell no.
What have you been up to?
Shit.
It's not me, you know?
Avoiding trees.
How was the storm? How was it over here?
Well,
I know Diego told me yeah, got fucked.
We were right here.
You were doing a podcast?
I was right there.
We were trying to.
And the storm was like,
bro. The storm literally walked behind me. I got off my truck and I heard, like, what the fuck? I literally get like probably like 10 steps from the door and I hear clack, 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 boom. And I look over and I'm like, what the fuck? I jump in, the fucking wind starts going hard, and fucking branches start falling. I'm like, he walks
I'm
in.
Like, so no,
sits down.
Me, Chris, and Gabe just in here chilling. We hear that fucking tree falls right beside the fan pond.
Yeah.
He walks in, I think, 30 seconds right after.
We open the door, check,
close it, opens again. This devil, he walks in.
We're like, oh my gosh.
He's like, did you see the tree? I'm like, yeah, I saw it. So then, the power went out.
Oh, fuck,
and
yeah.
And we're like, yeah, we probably don't want to do a pod today.
It flickered.
No, it flickered, then the transformer blew. Like, that was loud. So then, it went out. And then, the switch is in here. We're like, damn. I said, maybe we should, because we heard something right there. We're somewhere, I'm like, damn, maybe we should go. And then, we did like this, nigga, and then, boom, bro.
Because we started hearing, big rustling sounds like
no, nigga, it like, I meant, like, a neck cracking, and
I started.
I'm like, oh.
We
all fucked up.
I was the first one on the floor, and these niggas stared at me for, 1 second, right after that.
Bro, we all go in here like
this. I feel like I was the last one to cover.
Nigga, should we be here? Let's go. And then, bro, we didn't even know it was like that, bro. We were just trying to get out.
We didn't know until we,
we thought it was going to collapse.
We went inside, and then it calmed down, and we came to check. Yeah.
You got water leaking through it or no?
No.
It's a pinch of tough shit. It's tough shit.
They wasn't lying.
No soliciting, bro.
It was pretty tough. No
you build it?
Shit.
Not this time. We'll fix it though.
We'll fix that motherfucker though.
I don't know how to fix it, yeah? For real?
We already know how to fix this bitch.
You're gonna need the scrap.
Never mind.
Oh. My fault. What's your social security again?
Nah, I'm just kidding.
Shit,
nothing much.
Fuck
that.
What's
that?
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. That box? That's a light. I purchased a light that I could control, like the temperature and the brightness and shit.
Oh, yeah?
I just need like a large softbox.
So, Lalo, how often do you go to the gym?
5 times a week.
Fuck.
Like Monday through Saturday.
How long?
Look, that's how long are you there?
No, Sunday. I don't go Sunday.
You said 5 days a week, and you said Monday through Saturday.
That's oh, shit. Days. My bad. Cut that out. Cut that out.
Nah. But,
you go 6 days or five?
5 days. Oh, 5 days.
But, like, how long were you at the gym?
This new gym I'm at right now, it takes me about like 45 minutes to be done because it's a small one. It's not crowded at all. So it's like super, super chill. I just do my own stuff and that's it.
That's good. Like, I always believe in, like, you don't have to be in the gym long
to get a good workout in.
Like, you don't have to be there 2.5 hours.
Oh, no. Some people would be fucking. There's still this girl that goes there. She stays there for like probably like 3 hours. I was like, bro, what the fuck are you doing?
Do they just go really slow? And
They really don't work out, but they just stay there, like, talk to people and socialize. So I'm like, the fuck are you doing?
Feel comfortable there.
I guess so, yeah.
Go downtown.
I don't know what the fuck
I don't know what that means happened. Go downtown.
What's downtown? Library.
It's library. Oh.
Huh? I'm sorry.
I guess. You ever
tried
Zumba?
Tried what?
You ever tried Zumba?
I never tried Zumba.
You ever tried Herbalife? Bitch.
Yeah, I know your mom bought the products for sure, bro. My mom did.
I love that cookies and cream smoothie, bitch.
And then the Savila.
Oh my gosh. Have you heard about... It used to be next to where El Pueblo used to be. Where he is.
Metro PC. You know Metro PC has that little one?
Yeah, it used to be there, but before it was right next to... Where that was at. Because I remember they used to do Zumba there, and they sold Herbalife.
Damn. There used to be people riding around with the Herbalife.
Yeah.
And Tahoes and shit.
They
right?
Still, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
People still be on
it. Have you seen the fucking Taggy at también?
Money for real, I guess.
Shout out, Piña.
I wonder how people make money off those things.
What people buy their products and like they commission,
Harry
basically.
And
oh.
The, all that other shit.
Avon.
Whoa.
People really be having the
money. Man, that's some black shit, bro. Oh my god, man. I know this lady. I don't remember so many people that sell Avon.
I know.
The lady even at the church.
I know. The lady across. You remember seeing the freaking the catalogs they used to smell?
Yes, bro. Here, smell this, but you want that? You want that, bro?
From Mary Kay.
Yeah, bro.
They get a specific color.
I am 8 years old. Why don't you have me smell Avon at church, bro?
Mary Kay on it. Yeah, you only get that color fucking Cadillac whenever you sell a lot of products, I believe.
Every kiss begins with
that's not the same time. We're talking about selling drugs legally.
No, that's Herbalife.
That is Herbalife.
That's Herbalife?
Herbalife
is smoothies.
I don't fucking know.
Herbalife is smoothies.
And like beverages and health.
It's like losing weight. Kind of like that.
For real?
There was one thing I used to... Some like about coffee, Organo Gold. I remember that shit. My parents.
This is that black coffee, whatever.
Yeah.
My mom drinks that.
Hell yeah! My mom and dad were in that bitch for a while, probably like
1, 2, 3 years. Niggas acting like it's a mafia.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, it was about
the
that
coffee
shit.
Was good as fuck.
Okay.
Hey, they had like different packages, like yellow one, like for like I think cold coffee.
You
like,
try Colombian? I mean, freaking Dominican coffee.
Hey, no cap. That coffee was pretty good.
That shit was good.
I would just something to do hot as
bro, they got
a
fucking hot shit. Ass fucking...
We got fucking coffee in 90 degrees weather, bro.
I was pissed off. Who the fuck gives me that? Give me some fucking iced water, please.
I swear.
Fuck. We just literally put out our cigar, fucking mouth all parched, give us some fucking coffee.
Shit, and fucking hot chocolate.
I like coffee. Hot chocolate.
Yeah, it was cool because it was like subtle sweet, but tasted like black coffee.
Oh, I tried this, Freak, am I remembering right? It was a Middle Eastern coffee. Okay.
Where'd you try that shit?
You're drinking battery acids. it looked like an espresso. It is espresso. What is it?
It's sangre.
It's sangre.
I remember that. I heard that from us.
Quinn? No, mamas.
What were you saying about the espresso?
It was nasty. That was talking about coffee.
Maybe you made a sound good.
You didn't round it out. You just.
I forgot where it's from, so it doesn't matter.
So what else did we have? Basically, everywhere you fucking went, they're giving you a shot, coffee, chocolate, and a cigar.
So yeah, wake up in the morning, drink, and that's it.
Yeah.
God.
Yeah. We literally have breakfast with like
a shot, baby.
A drink, like a drink.
Fucking eggs.
Gave down there with fucking eggs, bacon, a sausage, and a fucking strawberry daiquiri.
Red and blue.
Demos were fire.
Shot of Patron for mouthwash in the morning.
Oh my gosh. At some point.
Well, yeah, we can't use the water.
Oh, yeah, you drink the water from the tap.
You can't drink the water from the tap.
What? You can't even rinse your mouth with that shit.
Hell no, we're in here with a fucking water bottle and a fucking
I don't forget escape. Every morning, but.
I forgot one time after that I've used a bottle of water.
One day I got sick.
No, I was straight.
Whoa, that's probably
that's why, good. Why, nigga? My stomach has not been right in that bed.
At no all.
Funny shit, bro.
Shit.
Bro, I we have... I the water over there.
It's not clean enough.
It wasn't clean.
Like, being over there making me laugh, like...
Like, you wake up, though. You... Fuck!
Fuck it, I'm already using
I'd rinse my... If I noticed, I'd rinse it out with that... What was the name of the water? The first day it was Arizona. The second day it was Alabama.
What? I don't know what the fuck it is.
3 liter
Alaska. I don't know what it was. Alaska. Alaska. I would say Alaska.
Big ass waters.
Alaska, Alabama.
Man, I don't know, bro. I just know that.
Hey, but it helped with the immune system. That hole was 1.5 liters, bro. That shit was easy.
It was big ass fucking waters. It was pretty cool. I got a picture of me.
Oh, shit. What the fuck?
That shit is a picture of me, bro. That's the type of water they have in Mexico, too.
That whole 1.5 liters.
Never been to Mexico.
Big. No?
Never.
Dude, how old are you?
I can't even lie.
21.
I've been like
you
once.
Haven't gone for
never,
it?
Never.
Next year.
I need to go.
Been once. Chihuahua. Anybody?
Type shit. The food is fucking amazing.
Where?
I'm trying to go to Mexico, Mexico. To witch hunt, bro. I'm trying to go say. See some witches.
What? If you said yeah, Dominican, I'd be like,
what? Some witches, yeah.
We should do that.
So what?
We should witches, do that like, shit.
We should go hunting for that shit.
We should go hunting
for
that
shit.
I'm down for that shit.
I'm down for that.
Wait, porque
bro, like a group of people.
Wait, this witch hunting.
Witch hunting?
Yeah.
Hey, cuz.
Hey, chill. You gave me chills.
Nigga, their energy hey, sticks
you
to you.
With that shit. Chill the fuck
their
out.
Their energy sticks to you if you fucking. But there's a big ass way.
We can just jump the witch. Like,
bro.
It won't fucking like,
deeper,
oh shit, there's
fuck. It's deeper than that. Yeah, wait.
Flies away in the broom.
You gotta run faster than water, everybody bro. Else.
Holy water.
You luego? Let's stick to the last
we're
person.
We're fucking after, but yeah.
You're gonna try to throw it at us. You're just gonna keep flying.
Hey. Pinche in Arizona.
You think they're real witches?
Hell yeah. Well, I'm out there. I don't believe that they're dig. Real, but I wouldn't count it out either.
You know, I don't have an opinion on that. Maybe. Maybe not.
I do believe in.
Well, I've seen a lechuza before, so I guess I do believe.
Other shit.
Yeah, brothers.
Bro, what the fuck? Nigga, you're dark as shit.
Yeah. Because you don't. Oh, well, he barely started wearing a long sleeve.
Damn, they
burnt. It happens.
Burnt the bean for real.
What did he say?
Chico Wapo.
Chico Wapo. If you think about it, my what? DNA has probably changed.
What would you say?
You that? Know, they debunked the fact that your DNA doesn't change.
How did your DNA change?
There's such thing.
Oh, my nigga.
Quay?
What do you think about evolution? It's adapting to your environment, right?
Yeah.
Animals go through that. Humans go through that too.
We in what way though?
So why do you think
people... Like you can sustain more heat now or what?
Why do you think...
Fuck no, I threw
okay,
up.
Okay, so I'm not gonna lie.
Wait,
I'm not being serious. Wait.
Look. No cap, no racist. Why do you think they have a darker pigmentation on their skin? More melanin. Why do you think so?
Because they're from Wakanda.
Because obviously over there, they're in the sun.
Where's over there?
They're closer to the equator.
Yeah, where's over there?
Africa.
How the fuck you know from Africa?
I heard it was Egypt. They were
Egypt. Everything. Yeah. All those countries over there. Huh. They're closer, like to the equator.
So they've always been more exposed
to the sun.
So that's why
they adapted to their environment. They have a more melanin. It's harder for them to get sunburn and stuff like that. Why do you think white people get red and burn?
But to a
their skin starts peeling and shit.
Because they don't adapt to sun as well.
Exactly.
So to a certain extent, when do people become like not become your cousins?
What?
Bro, y'all have to understand what I'm talking
about. What?
Yeah, I get what you mean.
You get what I'm saying?
I understand,
like if it all like boom, 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 boom. Like,
I think it's so far that we wouldn't even been able to actually like pinpoint
it. I think after like my cousins.
Because you lose track after second cousins. I do. I don't know what my third cousin is beyond this motherfucker right here.
Honestly, yeah. I just know my, like, right away, the cousins that I have.
Your fourth cousins, that, I don't even think really have blood like that.
Because look.
Because it all gets mixed.
By the time it gets to you, you're going to only know, like, your cousins, right? Then from there, you don't know so much of them. And they have kids. You're not going to know all of their kids. They're going to have kids. All of them probably won't know each other by, like, what is that, three generations maybe?
Three, four generations.
But that don't mean they're like,
I don't even think you live long enough to touch it.
Even if you think about it, bro, I have primas that have kids already, and sometimes their kids don't recognize me after like you know, because it's always been like, it always like a while before I see them again for some reason, like parties or something. And then they see me again, and it's, some of them don't recognize me. And they're like, "Who's that?" And my abuelita said, "Like, that's your CEO."
Whatever.
He's Joshua, or whatever. You know, mm-hmm. It's just kind of like that. Like, imagine, you know, sooner or later, they're not gonna know who I am. I mean, we don't hang out all the time. Like, you know, they got their own lives. We got our own lives. And
yeah, because I still haven't met everybody in my family. We've been second because a lot of them, they don't even live here.
And sometimes people. Like, sometimes people, family live right there, like, in the same city and everything, but no se juntan, you know?
Yeah, you don't even
see. People that don't get together, like, anything.
Oh, yeah.
That's why that happens, too, like, you know?
Kinda some cousins don't like each other for no reason, shit like
exactly,
that.
Exactly, you know? Just because, like...
They stop talking, and their kids are gonna start dating. Because they don't... How are you gonna know what he looks like? How are you gonna know what your cousin looks like?
Hey,
you
exactly, never, that's what happens. Never hang out. That's what happens.
You never hang out, you never seen this guy.
Small-ass city...
Go to the same high school. Everybody, there's only two. You go to the same high school? You're Hispanic. I'm Hispanic. You like the same music. Let's chill. Kind of look the same. Little weird. Fuck it.
And then? Baby with six fingers. Fuck.
Two dicks.
All right.
Dick.
Abagussi.
But you see where it could get confusing, but after, like, when shit starts to get serious, people fucking wonder, like, you got that? Am I related to this person?
The other bad option.
Have you not ever wondered that?
No.
No?
But I get you, where you're
coming
from.
What are you talking about?
Bitch, when I was saying, like, bro,
I think just yapping.
Why you gotta be so rude?
I was saying...
You don't get it.
What if you slept with your second cousin? Whatever that happens to you. But what do you do?
Shit. Ditch your cousin.
Date your cousin? Fuck it.
I'm just playing. Don't date your cousin.
So in all cases of like cousins, in all cases of cousins like doing the deed, like it's 100% sure that they're gonna come out, like the kids are gonna come out with.
No. It's not 100%.
Right?
It's
more
likely.
It's
likely. More likely.
There's gonna be something wrong with them though.
More. Hey, it's really
there
common.
Might be a mild case.
More than you think about it. It's like really common in other countries and like stuff like that.
You haven't seen the video of that family that literally like they're all the of buffet? Them are like,
oh, they're in a basement and shit like that, or
they're in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah.
You ever seen that family with
in like a shed?
Like, he used to record the videos of them at the buffet and like with little Mexican music and they're like look so wholesome. I remember when I used to go with my family. You remember? You don't see those videos?
Mm-hmm.
Fuck! I'm gonna try to find it. Turns out, him and his sister, and his wife, a half sister, really. They have the same dad, different mom. And they got married and had kids together.
Knowing?
Yes.
What the fuck?
They were stepbrothers all along.
That's not still. What's that?
Still? That's weird.
That's still weird, bro.
How do you share that story with somebody? How'd y'all meet? Well,
our grandma's house.
My daddy's nutsack.
You just came first.
Yeah, I was in the left one, she was in the right one.
Oh my gosh, we were neighbors for a while.
Oh, yes.
We were neighbors for a long time, actually.
Y luego, what do you think of the bloodline?
Right now? Crazy as fuck.
Oh god.
You saw that, what's his name? Jago Fatu came up out of nowhere?
Hey.
You watch wrestling?
I started watching it because of him.
Yeah,
I don't
like
get
right
into
now.
It deep. But I, after like something happens, I do go and watch highlights.
It's basically like a Marvel opening like a DC universe now because companies can collab now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Or like NXT and TNA or some shit like that.
Yeah, because there was always a thing called like the Forbidden Door, and that's what like, that's basically like people, it was mostly in WWE because like it's the biggest like company wrestling wise. So they're going to be obviously more strict with their talent and shit. They're not going to let motherfuckers just go wherever and risk getting hurt somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
And then vice versa. Like, they're not just going to let whoever the fuck just come on their platform and then risk getting injured with somebody that isn't even worth... That doesn't even have a contract under them. But recently, they didn't do it on a main show, but NXT is like their developmental. So it's like...
They're rookies,
people,
basically.
Yeah, the people, they're rookies and they start... like, it's a smaller arena, smaller audience, obviously, but, like, it's more high intense. Like, they wrestle more risky, kind of, just because they're all, like, competing to get, like, a spot on their main roster. Like, because there's two brands, like, Raw and SmackDown, and they're all competing to go to whichever one, respectively. So now, recently, there's a company that back then, they gave WWE a run for their money, and it was called TNA. Mm-hmm. They died down for a while, and now they're starting to kind of come back. And there's a guy that's been over on social media, like, hella, and he popped up.
Joe Hendry?
Yeah, he popped up at the event, the NXT event, and then everybody was, like, going crazy and shit. Because it was, like, one of the first times it ever happened and whatever. They've been teasing it for a while, but now it's starting to happen.
And you should do wrestling.
Me? Look, yeah, you want to, bro. When I was little, bro, I swear, when I was little, I used to play with my bed.
People start out of nowhere with...
Bro, yeah. Like, I had my own character and stuff.
San Diego, you can do it too.
I literally had to retire because I injured my back.
Bro, fight that.
Technically.
Bro.
No,
I'm just saying. I was
like, oh my gosh.
He was doing it for real. Y'all missed the whole shit. He's retired right now.
Yeah, I retired. Come back. Never lost a match with my teddy bear, but yeah.
Hey. Hey, hey. Do
y'all ever have a holy teddy bear?
What was it?
I just heard what you said.
What? I think it's...
What'd you say? What? Repeat yourself. Boy.
Boy,
my ball.
I don't want to spam it, but I want to say it again. I'm sorry. You know what I want to say. But anyway, I said, did y'all ever have a hole in your teddy bear?
No. Yeah.
Yeah,
because I was wrestling him and I fucking opened it, and then that's how over time.
Oh, that's not what I put the hole there.
You yourself,
it was on the back end.
Oh, yeah,
thought to yourself, I'm gonna put a hole in this shit.
Yeah, so you're not
yesterday, bro. It's fucking me,
it's still there.
Nigga continuously buys teddy bears,
bro.
It's the same one, he's not a cheater, those he's faithful.
The big ones from Walmart, the huge ones.
No stuffing left.
The pillow socks.
Oh my gosh.
I talked to it, it's my emotional support.
Bro, fuck no.
No, bro.
So, hello? That's your friend.
What do you do? So, what do you do now, like, work wise?
Work wise, now I'm a personal trainer now.
Oh, yeah.
Personal trainer. I like it. I don't consider it like a job, because I just go in, train people, chill, hang out with people at work, and then eat and train people. It's not like...
What's up?
They say whenever you like what you do, you don't work it in your life.
That's what it is, yeah. I like having my own schedule. I can go to a haircut, come back, go eat, whatever. So it's pretty, like, settle shit.
Did you have to go to school for anything?
I had to do, like, to get my certificate, I had to do, like, something online, like a test. That took about, like, 7 months. It's take less, but it took 7 months because I took a break.
It was, like, a course?
Yeah, like a course. So I'd do that online.
I used to do that.
Yeah. It's pretty cool. It's fun, though. Pretty chill.
You still go to the same barbershop?
Same barbershop still.
Lavish,
yep.
Type of shit.
Okay, so what's, like, a crazy story you have while, like, training? No crazy stories? Nothing? Something you might be like, oh, my God, like...
Crazy stories.
Lady hitting on you.
No, I got gay dudes hitting up on me a lot.
There
gay
you go. Dudes, that's something interesting. What?
Now, I had a crazy story. So last year for my birthday, I went to Houston for my girl and then her brother and then my cousin, two other cousins. I went. We were just. It was like probably like after hours, shit like that. So it was like a dubstep club, like a lot of like beats and stuff. So we were chilling. And then we're about to leave, and then we're all of us in the circle. And then, I don't know, some random dude just came up, and, like, started talking to us. I'm like, oh, hey, what's up, blah, blah, blah. We'll get fake names and shit like that. And then I was with my girl. I think I had her like this. And then he asked my girl, is that your boyfriend? Oh, no, he told me, like, because I was wearing a hoodie, like a gym hoodie. So he was like, oh, I like that hoodie because it's a gym brand. I'm like, yeah, it's a gym brand stuff. Then yeah, I work out too. So he took his shirt off and shit, showed me his abs and ribs. I'm like, oh fuck yeah! I'm like, I'm not gonna be a dick. I'm like, oh, that's nice, bro. And then he looks at my girl, and he's like, is this your boyfriend? I was like, yeah. And then he went kind of close to me, but like, he's not gonna be there for long. So we just ignored it, and he kept asking me, oh, is this your boyfriend? I was like, yeah, we've been dating for like 2 years now. I'm like, oh, that's nice, but he's not gonna be your boyfriend no more. And then that's when I'm like, all right, we gotta go. But literally, that. So. I would say like last year, I was wearing some sweatpants my girl got for me. Oh. And I was training a client, and then I see this dude like on the stairmaster doing stairs, and I was with a client, and then I saw him look at me like a lot, so I'm like, I told my client, hey, is that guy looking at me? Like, or are you just, you know, just looking around like, nah, he's looking at you pretty weird, dude. And then an hour passes, done with my client. I was eating, I was in my truck for some reason. And then all of a sudden I get a text message from my Instagram. Like, I like your sweats. Where do you got them at? You look good on them.
Oh!
To this day, I haven't opened the message, bro. I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah, you gonna watch out, this?
Nah. Where did you get the sweatpants? If you're watching,
it was Sam's actually.
I got a big ass blister.
I still got it. Because
I had phones with no socks on, bro. I felt so fucking bad. Tell me why I had a backpack. And then like as soon as we came back to the resort after we did the
bro was in the pool shit, with Band-Aid on his foot.
Bro, yeah, I went out to the pool with a Band-Aid just so it wouldn't get there and it still got there. So tell me why the fuck. I opened my bag right before we get to the hotel after being gone for 4 hours on the door, but it was fucking socks in the backpack, bro. Bro, I was so mad. Bro, like, fuck, I don't even care.
Bro, as soon as we got there, they gave us mimosa, right?
Like champagne or something?
It was like champagne or something. It was
some watermelon to drink.
Yeah, it was some watermelon.
Oh, yeah.
It had a little kick to it. We go up to our room, whatever. And
Diego breaks his drink right away.
I finish that shit, I put it down, I turn around, it's on the floor.
Glass everywhere.
The whole time we think the fucking lights don't work. We think the fucking TV doesn't work. We're like, man, what the fuck? So, someone pulls up. Well, there was someone outside, and we're like, hey, how do we turn the lights on, whatever? And then he goes, I bet. They gave us two cards each. They get the card. He puts it in a little slot thing. Everything turns on. Fucking AC turned on.
God.
Hell yeah.
You're on the speed.
And then, but then it took him forever to go sweep the fucking shit up.
Hell yeah.
We're there waiting.
We're trying to go downstairs, but we're waiting for them to come in. So what's the crazy story you guys have?
The vibes.
From the dealer. Oh, nigga! Oh my god, bro! The worst part about the trip was when we first got there.
The food.
No, wait. Bro, whenever we got there, we got the plane with the customs, all that shit. So then we get on the van, right? And so, like, this lady comes on. She's like, hey, I'm your tour. Let me know if I have any questions. Then this guy jumps on the van. And he's like, hey, it's going to be like a 30-40 minute drive to the hotel. Let me know what you want, beer or water. So I'm like, oh, shit, I want a beer, nigga. This nigga say he want water, beer, water. Everybody like, oh, hell yeah, give us some. Nigga, we get it, we open it. Bro, tell me why this nigga get on the van and say.
No, he gives everybody everything, gets off for like 5 minutes, and then comes back.
Comes back and says, water, $1, beer, $5.
We're already halfway done.
And we started laughing. Be like, no, I'm serious.
God.
I was like, what the fuck? I'm like, bro, I just got scammed, nigga. Literally. Because whenever we get to the resort, our shit was already paid for, so it was going to be free.
Yeah.
I thought that was paid for as well.
Exactly. I thought that nigga was with him, bro. Niggas got him.
So you just got in for no reason?
Bro.
Random dude.
I mean,
type shit.
Right?
It's funny because he had a routine, because, like, I'm pretty sure whenever he left everything with us, he went down, introduced himself to the next bus, did the same thing. Came off, got the money, did the same thing, went to the next bus, and just kept doing it. Because it was like 20 buses waiting, just scattered everywhere, like parked different ways. And then, bro, like the taxi scene over there, it's crazy,
nigga,
bro.
Driving is crazy.
Motherfuckers literally like
swerving to all close to each other.
There's four guys on a scooter.
Four guys on a fucking scooter, bro.
Imagine us four on a scooter.
Like, no bullshit. Like, these niggas are getting around town, bro. Here going up to the street. No, these niggas are going to fucking parties. Fucking South Tyler, bro.
Going to work.
Nigga, for real, bro.
Going to get a haircut again. Type shit. Hey, are you hungry? Let's go to the stove. Hey, okay, that's how they look.
Like, we're going 60 miles per hour. Motherfuckers are starting to like get right past those fucking forks. Then they go shopping and shit. One lady had like
chairs.
She had a chair, like three chairs. Like she
and the scooter.
The guy was driving, and then she was like behind him, but she had the chairs like pointing outwards, like this way, on a moto, and then she held, she was like holding
it, like, around. Fuck.
So the chairs were in between them. And her arms were around the chair, holding
family's it. Way. Like, there was a mom that had two kids in between her and her husband was driving. Like, they were like,
hell yeah.
No helmet, just like
55
fuck.
55 miles no an helmet. Hour way. No on dirt. It's crazy.
Pavement, all that shit.
Wait, and then, like, you're literally, like, you know how there's, like, they'll have, like, medians. The medians?
Yeah.
Literally, you look over like this, there's, like, four to six, like, almost damn near eight guys just chilling there, like, sharing the same vape. Fucking Tekashi 6ix9ine on the vape and shit.
Swear to God. Tekashi 6ix9ine on the vape?
He has a brand of vapes.
He has a brand.
And I'm guessing they sell mostly on that side of America.
South America? South America?
South America, I mean, yeah.
Hell yeah.
We saw one at the... Where the Doom Buggies? Where we did the Doom Buggies? $60 for a vape wear. Wow.
60?
60,
bro. That's a Kashi's face.
What did y'all... Do y'all still... Like, how do you feel about vaping?
Overrated.
Never done it. Never vaped.
You feel like it's better than cigarettes?
Do some perks, bro.
I'm playing. I feel like it's worse than cigarettes.
Vaping? Bro, because you gotta think about it. Something electrically is like... Like, if you think about it,
Like, all the fumes and stuff like that will gain your fucking
metals
shit.
And shit.
Yeah.
Fucking
it's gotta Metallica. Be fucking love.
The band? So,
yeah. I say heavy metal, so.
There's still, like, heavy metals in physical stuff, too. You just have, like,
double entendre
and shit.
What's your favorite? Do you have anything that you're kind of like, I know I shouldn't do?
You have a vice?
Yeah.
Have a what?
Like a vice.
Vicio, for like what? For like...
Anything.
Anything?
You like, maybe this isn't that good for me, but I know I like to.
Like, do we gambling or...
Yeah. Everything eating. Is bad for you. Like, you know, everything's bad. The food is bad for you.
You see?
Nowadays, everything.
Yeah. That was something you struggle with? Like, maybe like not eating...
I want to say it's not eating because, you know, like everybody fucking needs ice to eat. But
like eating the stuff you want, like...
Yeah,
yeah,
you just fucking eat it, like, you know, it's not gonna hurt you if you do it once in a while, but if you do it every day, yeah, it's gonna fuck you up.
Whenever you eat a lot, like more than you should, like what's it called?
Obesity?
No, what was it? Like
when you eat over there, overeating?
Being fat.
It's like biblical almost.
Oh, okay, so you're being,
fat as fuck.
I forget the word.
No, I know what you're saying.
Gluten, whatever the fuck it is.
Yeah.
I'm not saying you're doing that. I'm just saying like that's
breaking a sin.
Huh? I'm just saying like that's a thing.
Yeah, yeah. Gluten is a form of greed and not to give or to.
It's more into greed, more things. But yeah.
So basically, like eating because you feel like that's bad. Yeah,
that is bad. But what? Why? What is this again? Eating because what?
Just like so, say. You have no reason to be eating. You just ate maybe like an hour ago.
Yeah, for example, me, basically. I eat not every hour, but like five meals a day. And then I don't think that's what it means.
Like
I don't have to eat a lot.
A long way too, because your intention is like,
your intention become is healthier. For like healthy for your body.
Yeah.
Gluten can also like, be for like, it's kind of like you go to the store, you see a chocolate. Ooh, I want a chocolate. You get the chocolate. And then you go down the street, you see Starbucks. I'm feeling Starbucks because I want some now too. It's like basically not knowing how to stop yourself from like getting everything that you're wanting to eat.
True, I guess
like, eating and stuff, like being like that.
Yeah,
because it ends up being obese after a while.
Yeah,
like
you just that's how people get obese.
Yeah,
just, like,
true.
They can't control their desire to eat.
Do you have a fast or a slow metabolism?
I have a fast metabolism.
For real?
That's why I do so much. Yeah.
Like shitting fast.
Is that natural?
Natural, yeah. I don't think it's natural, but I think just my body, the way I just grew up and playing sports and stuff. Sorry.
Often do you shit?
Because when I met
every
when
hour,
I met,
2 hours.
Same way.
Genetic? Is that like genetic? Like
I think it's genetic and just half your body too.
Because when
like
I met
that.
Him, he was skinnier than me.
Yeah.
I saw a picture of
you guys.
I think you posted it.
Yeah, I started at 105 pounds like 6 years ago when I was
beating him by like 10 pounds.
Yeah.
Oh.
I wanted to say, well, he's older than me.
No.
Hey, wait, you can get 13 champs.
Hell yeah.
Hey.
Hell
yeah.
They go back then, you used to go, right? Back then? You took like four scoops of pre-workout?
Damn.
Threw the fuck up.
throwing up in the stall.
I watched back that footage the other day.
Yeah, there's so many people that died in that China King buffet.
Bro,
you ever been
in
China King buffet recently?
Long time ago.
Maybe. Maybe take pictures of people now on the camera that
the
people that died.
That they don't pay and shit like that.
Yeah.
Huh.
They posted on their Facebook too.
There was a lady that works at my job that did that. They took a picture of her and her daughter. Oh, I should be
saying
that.
I don't know. I thought you just have to pay. Do you not?
You can walk out with it.
I didn't know that. I thought you get in trouble.
They don't catch you if you don't want. If they don't catch you, and especially it's easy at a buffet because people are just walking around giving you drinks. You're getting your own food.
You don't get your ass if you do it.
But don't you pay before?
No.
No, it's at the end.
But you would think all the cameras every fucking where. I mean, look where you're at right now.
You would fucking think that you pay before. What the fuck?
No, type shit. You should like.
Man, they probably should have changed it by now. And see so many people.
I mean, if it's not a buffet, I would think it'd be a standard.
Some buffets.
But, Golden Corral?
A buffet?
Golden Corral, you pay before CC's? You sit down.
Really? Yeah, CC's también. Yeah.
Ah!
CC's?
See, look, I think they need to take a fucking tip or two about fucking how they need to take money.
CC's.
Maybe. I don't know.
They're closing in September.
Who? CC's are closing?
What? Is
what?
Thanks for what?
I'm just playing.
Oh, I was like, damn.
See how easy it is to spread false information on the internet.
Very easy.
Fuck you.
Don't believe everything you see, guys.
What you going for, Biden or Trump this year?
Man. Shit. Neither.
Shit. Or
tax.
I just want things to go down. Fuck.
Tired of.
Bro.
Why would you ask me that?
Yeah. If you pay taxes, you pay taxes when we got lunch today.
Wait, hold on. Are you paying taxes?
Hey,
it's just because I saw that like the government hasn't been able to pass like their, you know, whenever the IRS like investigates you,
mm-hmm.
they haven't
audit,
been
yeah
their audit, they haven't been able to like explain where their money is going, like the tax money that we pay.
Well, supposedly,
but all that money is going to child trafficking.
I heard.
That's where it is. It has to be there.
But it's a scam, bro. Like, basically,
the Rothschild.
The president
there you
of
go.
Salvador is saying the same thing. Have you heard that nigga talk?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a very,
TikTok.
To land war,
very, very smart.
They're calling him
the Antichrist.
No, not him. I've seen the other.
Which one?
The young guy?
Yeah, him. The young guy. He can't be no Antichrist. Have you seen
so many theories just porque?
Have you seen the guy?
God means the savior.
Something in something like over there in the Middle Eastern, they call him the Antichrist.
Oh, that young kid?
Yeah,
I've seen him.
The young kid.
I feel like it'll be inevitable. Like, whenever it is, like, it's going to be, like, obvious.
I don't think we're going to be alive when that shit happens. Then we're all going
to
be dead.
I think we're very close to it, though.
You think so?
I've seen it. So many things that I just feel like it could happen right now.
Life
could
literally change tomorrow.
Like
30. Look at the pandemic.
Can you see?
That shit happened.
Look
at
what my dad, he left, and then boom.
Bro. You know what that is.
Shit.
That's fucked up.
Oh,
that's fucked up.
God. I wasn't talking to you. He obviously had a father. Christopher Clark. Oh, no. Sedino Clark.
I think it said Christopher.
Or it says government name, bro.
Shout out, coach.
It's okay.
Dang. Did I ever tell you the story about how whenever me and Lalo were working at Walmart, and then our head boss, like store director, caught us like messing around, and he was like in the fucking trash can.
Oh my god! Yeah,
we were fucking around, right in the back. Like we're just messing around.
Oh, dude! Fuck!
Because like usually towards the end of our shifts, they let us like fuck around and like people for the night got there. Yeah, it's quit, so we could go stock fucking bullshit all that 2 hours. We're taking one of the trash cans. We're like, Lalo, jump in there. It was me, him, and Renee.
Right? I think, yeah.
We're like, just jump in the trash can. We're fucking around.
There was nobody there, bro.
He looks around, he fucking jumps, and then he slips in, and he like falls fucking, and it's like in the big black like vent, so he's like he can't really move unless somebody pulls him out.
I was like this, like I can't fucking.
And as soon as he like touches down, and we laugh and turn around, the freaking store director comes by, and she stops, and she's like,
What are you doing? And then the motherfucker says, I dropped my wallet in here.
Bro, that was quick though.
We fucking pulled him out. Fucking halfway there, we were looking at her, and she just like, she just looked like that and then kept walking. But bro, we got away with so much shit.
Yeah.
We got away with so much shit. Yeah.
I think she said it backwards.
Oh yeah, she was like backwards. And we're like, and he was like, yeah. Hell no. And then we used to have this guy that would come in on a scooter.
Like, who the fuck is that?
She was so fucking slow, bro. And he had a Make America Great hat, bro. He was so racist, way. So fucking just walked by us and. Look at us, ugly. Look at us.
Can we say shit?
No, we can't say it. We'll probably get in trouble if you say something.
No, but like, would he say anything to y'all?
No.
Like, butt bags?
Anything? Nah, he just, the aura. Had no aura. He
gave off
racism. What else happened there? Probably, there had to be some crazy shit that happened there.
It's probably more. I remember when I walked in, Sam taking a shit on the private restroom.
Bro.
The guy was taking a shit on the lights when lights were off.
Tramp.
Have you ever shit yourself?
No, not yet.
You've never shat yourself.
Never shat myself.
Damn.
That's cap.
Okay. I guess.
Ain't no cap way. I came back from Dominican. Bro. Niggas. I was scared as fuck at work, bro.
Like, I feel bad for you because when you had taken, you like, bro, I feel so sick. Like, you feel how I feel. It may have been the water, fucking. But nigga, I was like, damn, this nigga finna be around raw chicken all day.
Smelling raw chicken, fucking heat, fucking.
Thinking about the wrong shit. You're gonna be around canes, cooked chicken,
chemicals, with
the fucking toast, then down,
garlic,
cane sauce all day.
Garlic.
Any upcoming events at Canes?
Nigga, y'all have garlic bread.
Oh, it's garlic spread that they put on the bread.
It's always been garlic spread.
Hmm? It's garlic.
What?
No
wonder is that.
That's the difference. Huh? It's not butter, bro. It's garlic spread. Like, it's made for
special events. Like,
it's not made to be milk. It's supposed to be cold. That's why.
And I was listening to him. Like, at just same time.
I guess. I've never really tasted the garlic part though. It just tastes like toast with butter.
I don't know. I feel like the way that I used to eat it before, it doesn't taste the same. So it's always been the same shit, same ingredients, but it doesn't taste the same to me anymore.
Oh yeah, well you worked there forever.
Forever?
Whoa.
Well, when I used to work at Go Fish, that shit started tasting different after a while too. The fried sushi I used to like, I stopped liking it because the fried stuff.
Do we still have a Go Fish?
Bro, I get the shits with Go Fish, bro. Yeah. What's the secret? Like what?
I don't know, it's just sushi, bro. Probably the seaweed is getting to you or something. The rice, I don't know.
If y'all could fly away, like, what super on some superhero shit,
I'm fine, let's what go stance, get some food, nigga.
What stance would you fucking do before you take off?
Nigga.
I'm just dipping.
Fuck it.
I think I'd have to do, like, a flip.
Fuck all that.
Go flip!
Nigga, you're gonna flip and then go straight into the ground, nigga.
Imagine, like, around? A backflip.
You a little drunk?
No, imagine I do, like, a...
You little drunk,
flat straight into the ground, man.
Little drunk back in the pool.
Hell no. Nah, but for real, like, imagine I do a backflip, and then I, like, make my body like this, like, right before I hit the floor, and then I take off.
Like, how?
Okay, so, like, if I'm doing a backflip, let's say, like, I'm about to face plant, like, straight onto the floor. So if I'm doing a backflip this way, I'm gonna be basically on my tummy straight.
Yeah,
you know, like right that. Before I hit the floor.
I guess, nigga, until you forget.
That's even if you get to that point.
No, but I'm saying you're going to hit this lamp. Bro, if you can fly, I'm pretty sure you can go backflip.
That's true.
I only started thinking about this because I started watching all the Iron Man movies again. Motherfucker, there's so much shit, badass shit in there.
What's your favorite superhero?
Spider-Man.
Of course. I like Spider-Man. That's
you?
Captain America.
I like Thor and Spider-Man. Thor and Spider-Man are all
Thor's movies are badass.
Yeah, they're funny as fuck, too.
Black Panther? Yeah.
Yeah. I like Black Panther.
I was gonna say that shit too, nigga. Fuck. I'll wait till he got quiet.
Fuck on the braver. RP, my nigga.
Hey, you the.
I'm pretty sure.
Planet of the Apes.
You see? Have you seen that monkey, the little dumb one? Sessa. Now, have you seen that little dumb monkey? Like, he said, oh, like, no.
Motherfucker's hella curious.
Bad monkey.
Okay, I'm cooking in here.
Damn.
So what type of ground beef do you eat? Like 80-20, 73-27,
93-7?
Fuck, how?
I heard there was 95-5.
There is.
The red one. I just know it's the red one.
90 and up. Like, it's hella variations. I remember stocking that shit. You remember that shit?
The blood fucking cook come out.
What's the difference?
Just the grease and fat. Yeah, the green ones.
Lean to fat ratio.
What's better?
The green one. That's expensive, but it is.
Hey, but if you go to Sam's, it's green.
You said the green one?
Sponsored by Sam's.
Grass-fed and shit.
I tried grass-fed before. I think
green is 85.15, right?
I think so, yeah. That's like the best one you can get, basically. The green.
Is that the one expensive one?
Yeah, it's like $25, and there's like probably like this
one.
The red
one, they're 80-20, and then there's 73-27.
But you can see like the grease when you're cooking it. You can fuck. It's a lot of
fun. So what's the one thing that your girl does that just gets you in like upset? Like one thing that he's just saying and just like.
You need a hug, bro.
You know.
You go first.
You go first.
Yeah.
Me.
You go first. Yeah.
So recently. Recently, she told me that I take too long in the toilet, and low-key, that kind of bothers me because it's just like,
that's my me time.
What am I supposed to do? You know, I have to shit, and it's not my fault that I take too long.
No, you can. You can try to shit faster.
Man,
you can. Technically.
Oh my god.
Technically.
Now you're choosing sides. Now you're choosing sides, bro.
We'll talk. But anyways. Alright, whatever. You know what? Whatever.
No, I'm asking. It was technically a question. Bro, like, do you feel like you can?
Shit.
No, or do you pace yourself?
I feel like I'd be shitting.
I'm like, shut up.
At a nice pace.
When I'm done,
you're done.
Sometimes, like, you just choke. I feel like if I wait a little bit, I might shit more, and it happens. You so see? I'm taking shit. I'll be done like in what, a minute or two, but then I sit there for like another minute, and then next thing you know, again.
It's because you don't want to get up, walk like to your room, and then be like,
I gotta shit more.
And then you lay down, your stomach starts hurting.
Nigga, I've been on the toilet for like 20 minutes.
Yeah, this is not good. Time. She tells me that she doesn't like it because it's not good for me, and I can get hemorrhoids and.
Well, to be sitting in that position?
What?
Yeah.
Well, like, what about when you sit down in your chair, like right now?
No, but it's not the same.
Because your ass is exposed.
No, it's just the toilet bowl has a way of making your.
Don't they have like a little chair that you sit like that?
No way.
You sit what?
I think they have like a little stool, right? Then you can sit and it makes your posture a little bit better.
You gotta think about it where you're putting pressure on that outskirt.
So tell me, no. Right now, you're sitting, right? Uh-huh. But if you do a squat.
I'll butt plug in.
Bro, how do you get those? I can't get.
You said how you get them out?
Shit, I mean.
What were you talking about?
The damn hemorrhoids, bro.
You can get hemorrhoids, I guess. I don't know.
So, are you fine getting hemorrhoids?
No, but like, it's kind of.
You've
like,
sat in the toilet for a long time, right?
Yeah.
22 years. You ever got a hemorrhoid?
Not yet.
Wow. Well, actually, I've been starting to sit on the toilet recently. It's been like, kind of like 6 months or something. Like,
you hit the. 6 months that you ever lean back?
Uh-huh. You could be on the toilet. Newspaper.
You can be off the side.
Yeah. I'll be on my phone like this. I'll be putting my phone right here. Sometimes I'll be wiping, and my phone's right here, and I'll just wipe. And then I'm not done. So I'll just keep watching.
Yeah. You see how addicted we are to cell phones? We can even.
Yeah, exactly.
Prime example.
Yeah, right there.
Yeah, I've been thinking about it too.
Shit's around his phone.
How often do you feel like you're on TikTok?
Too much.
A lot.
I feel like TikTok caused that.
Even our parents are on TikTok, bro.
What do you feel like?
Like, how the hell my mom's on TikTok?
TikTok, YouTube Shorts, all that shit, bro.
Reels.
On the way here, you were watching the video.
Yeah. We're watching on YouTube, though. I think, or Facebook.
Yeah, sometimes I feel like I just get lost in my phone, and when I read it, I'm like, fuck this phone.
But you gotta think, you're growing with a society that their aim is to keep you on the phone as much as possible.
Hell yeah.
So they're gonna keep doing
you
stuff. They want you to be on your phone as much as possible. That's why cell phone plans are always having deals. That's why fucking everything. That's why TikTok's free. Everything it's so accessible now. Like literally, they make everything more convenient and appealing for us.
Like think about it.
Like now we can make our own emojis. Like what
it's
the fuck?
All an agenda.
Like a movie star gets into a rig. What's the first thing people gonna do? They're not gonna help them. They go.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna post this shit.
Or have you seen that VR set that Apple came out? Bro, that you can go go like this and then click. Know,
bro, I want that shit. Has Meta glasses and the holes are
Really?
I don't know if you know that. You know what they are?
No.
Bro,
they're Ray-Bans with a camera.
They're Ray-Bans with a fucking camera on. You think this shit look like me blurry as fuck? No, nigga.
That shit clear as fuck.
This shit more clear than a phone. Sometimes you don't even know they're fucking recording, bro. That's how crazy this shit is.
This
like
some spy shit.
It's like $350, bro. The most
worth it.
There are.
But can you notice, like, you can see the camera just like super hit and slid.
It just depends, bro.
It's like a black little circle, but I'm
thinking there's some difference. You're not gonna notice there. You're like,
yeah, it's like where those circles are.
Yeah, literally like right there.
Oh shit.
Like, of course you can tell that night because like it's like white.
Like the lens and coming in.
You know what? If you post on fucking Instagram, it says but with Meta or whatever the fuck.
Oh fuck, that shit looks cool. But
I never seen it until I saw his brother's post. Like, I think it says shot with Meta glasses or some shit.
Well, have you seen that AI can like personate like your voice and shit? And then it's so weird. Imagine like shit happens like the president,
bro,
and we go to war after that.
This you picture see? I took of him with his glasses on.
No way.
I had his glasses on, bro. I swear to God. And then look at the top. It said made of Meta.
Oh, shit. That's so clear. Fuck. It looked like an iPhone.
Clear as fuck.
He was okay. Recording way. Like, just walking around the resort.
All I had to do was
clear as fuck. Damn,
that hoe is clean
as fuck.
Too
badass. Imagine how much shit we could have recorded if we had a pair on.
Hey, so here we go. We talked about it not so long ago. We talked about the Antichrist stuff. What you doing when it happens? You think you'd be scared? Like, what you doing? You're at whatever day, you hear the big ass trumpets.
The seven trumpets.
The seven trumpets. You turn to the side, some dude just. You turn to the side. 10, 15 minutes pass.
You're still here.
The news pops up that people disappeared. You're still here. What are you doing?
Pray. Pray to God. Yeah, my clock. I'm. But I think it's too late after that, right? Like,
I don't even know.
It's too late.
Sound,
yeah.
It's gonna be scary. It is scary. Have you heard about all the stuff that's gonna happen after that?
Like the flood and then the fire and then bugs will come eat you and stuff like that. My TikTok is all over that shit, bro. I have a client, bro, that is a Freemason.
What?
I swear to God.
Ain't that like Illuminati stuff?
It's like their own cult type shit. Like, I was training him, and he had, like, a little keychain. He was in the military, too, so he had the little dog chains and shit.
Yeah.
And in the corner, you can see, like, the little triangle with the little fucking symbol. And I looked at it, I was like, what the fuck? And then I told him, like, you're a Freemason? I was like, yeah, how you know about that? I'm like, oh, my whole TikTok is all over. Like a Freemason. And then I think I told him, like, you're a level 33. So level 33 on Freemason is, like, the highest rank you can be and shit like that over the years.
But what is it?
It's
what
like...
What do they believe?
I don't know how to describe it. It's just, like, their own cult. Like, I don't know. It's weird.
It's still like a thing.
Yeah.
It's Illuminati.
They said they're not, but, like, there's kind of like that little bit.
Yeah, okay, look. It's like a group gathering for a certain purpose, and they have a lot of money and resources.
It's like the people from the woods and shit, like... You remember the people from the woods?
They're high rank.
You were there, right?
Oh. I'd be going to all white parties.
Oh, that hurt.
You look white.
Oh, shit. He is white.
You can charge the light.
Puro blanco.
So, you never answered the question.
What?
What the Charles girl?
Shit. Fuck. I thought we were talking about the Antichrist. Fuck.
No, you never said anything.
Same.
Or like, what's the weirdest experience like on a date that you ever had?
Me and my girl, we're in Dallas. We went to go eat tacos at like 2, 3, 4 in the morning, however fucking late it was. Lit as fuck. Jams was playing. Tacos was fire. Little crust. Anyway, we get outside to the truck. I see type shit. I see like crackhead walking around. I'm like, okay, it's gonna be interesting. I told my girl, alright, well, let's get inside the truck. Let's hurry the fuck up. Let's go. So, cool. She made it inside. Luckily, I was still outside. She's over here like, hey, where you going? Can you give me a ride? I'll ride with you guys. I just hop in the back. That's okay, nigga. I was like, no, I'm fine. She was getting closer and closer and closer, bro. Didn't know what the fuck to do.
Yeah, fuck around.
Just rock her, bro. Fuck.
So basically, the bitch kept getting closer into my face, into my personal space. And I don't like that shit. Right? So I don't want to
hit her. It's a female.
You're and?
A
strike
woman. Well, I mean, she was in my face and shit. But then my girl's in there.
What race was she, though?
And she was white.
Oh.
And so...
Don't
so
do it.
I got this little thing where I look up in the distance and I'm like, oh, you mean you're hurt? And my facial expression, I believe, sells it. And I'm like, oh, hey, they're calling you. So the stupid bitch turns around. I laugh, but because I fucking laughed, it took too long. She turned around. I'm over here trying to get in the fucking truck. Hop in, close the damn door behind me. She's getting all mad and shit, hitting the fuck out of my truck. She's like, boom, boom. I'm like,
bitch, let me talk to you.
Nigga, I roll down the window. I grab a fucking something was full. It was a full drink. And then I'm like, that's not fucking right, nigga. And I put it back. And I'm like,
I was being now drinking drink that 0.5 seconds. Wait,
I almost took that shit to the back of her head. But
now you wanna know what?
That one was bop, bop, bop.
Nah, fuck all that. She would have done shit a lot. Like take Fulio type shit.
Type shit. Oh, like he used to need a ride. She's like, yeah. I'm like, bye, bitch. And I just left. Fucking dumbass. I should have fucking rocked this shit.
Have you heard about the Julio
thing? I did.
Ooh.
Supposedly.
It's crazy, way because the diss that he did, the diss he did on Young and Ace, he was talking about how his brother would ever died, or whoever the fuck it was, homie, yes, brother would ever died. And in the song he says, I think it was 4 shot, 3 dead, or like something like that. He said 4 shot, 3 dead in the worst way. Like that's what he said in the diss track towards homie. Fast forward, the way he dies, 4 people are there, like in the car or whatever where he got shot. He's the only one that got shot. Other 3 niggas survived. Motherfucker fucking... That's like instant karma, like karma. Not instant, but I'm saying like...
He predicted that bitch or
he
what?
He fucking talked so much shit on someone else, and then he
Isn't
died.
That one guy that was always like... saying crazy shit on his songs?
You know, yeah, he's the one that said, you know, the Who I Smoke?
I miss you.
That's the diss that was towards the guy, towards Julio. This is...
Okay, so we have a story to read.
Yeah, and Julio did he did the diss track at that guy's grave. And he had the poster of the newsletter, and he was like... Hell yeah.
I'm not gonna sleep on that.
Yeah, could you get pretty disrespectful?
The Jacksonville shit.
Like, if you were dropping a diss on your op, how far did you take?
Are we faking it or are we being real? I feel like all this is faking just for like, but I don't know about that.
Some niggas die.
Yeah, some people die. Yeah.
Okay, if it was like, if you were a star influencer and this was for publicity, and they're fair game, everything, go deep. How hard would you go? To the point where like, oh, this nigga wants to fuck me up.
I feel like he go deep. Into this shit.
I feel like he go deep.
I'll ask the person, like, can I go this deep and then we'll talk. But and then from there.
Nah, I would like to go deep and just fuck you.
If it's your fake for more money and views, yeah.
Just know that as deep as you go, it better be deeper than the deepest they can go with you.
Oh no.
Yeah. So if you're gonna say some shit, it's gonna be way worse than the worst shit on you.
You gotta be creative as fuck. Trust.
Cause bro, imagine how Drake literally fucking sitting at his fucking crib, fucking big ass Wango fucking hung ass motherfucker, just on his phone.
You just wanted to say that, bro.
Yeah.
You really shit. Just wanted to say that, bro.
I had
to. So, I find it like, kind of interesting how you like just think about that. You know?
Anyways,
you like imagine that you hear what you're thinking about.
Sometimes, but I think we all do.
I stopped thinking about that a long time ago.
Think about what?
Oh, you
Drake.
What?
I was thinking about you thinking about his fucking third leg?
I can't
hear it.
I haven't
even
seen the video.
Cap.
You fucking lying. We were all in here. Me.
Only motherfucker with a hat on.
We were all in here.
Don't we worry.
Cap and I swear.
I wasn't. Oh,
hell no.
I was not the only one.
Insert the clip right
here. I was fucking here. I saw the shit. I ain't gonna cap. That nigga showed me. One of y'all two saw the shit with me.
You said let me see.
Both of y'all saw.
Let me see.
Don't cap.
Don't
cap.
We seen different stuff.
I did not see
this
shit, but it's all the same.
No, nigga, no.
There's one angle.
No, that wasn't Drake.
It's not one angle.
Motherfucker said,
was it Young Boy?
It was beat. No, I'm
going. With Shawty Bae.
Oh.
What do you think about Shawty Bae, bro? Fuck.
You seen that?
I just want to rock her, bro. Fuck.
You seen that one video where she's like naked twerking in the OnlyFans?
Oh, no.
Have you seen her OnlyFans?
Yeah, that's what he said.
Bro.
Yeah. Bro, I ain't seen this shit.
Have you seen the video when she has a little... Bring a girl. Have you seen that one? When she has a little dog?
Hell no.
I wonder who told her that's like...
the way to go.
No one.
You didn't see
You know what's crazy?
Sexy redhead chick keeps chaining her underwear.
And you know what's crazy? People like that, like, they make videos like that and they still have a manager. Like social media manager. Like,
yeah.
Social media assistant.
They don't control their, like, their stuff. They have
bro, because they're still going to get paid.
Well, those OnlyFans pictures fucking... Somebody getting paid off them motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Somebody got a little freaking on it. Like, well,
let me that's where we draw the line for pocket.
Type shit.
Yeah.
Remember, you subscribed to Shotty Bays. So you
like, I have never subscribed to anybody's OnlyFans. Ever.
I'm just playing.
Ever. You hear that, babe? Sure.
And to put emphasis on it. But would you ever sell selfie pics?
I had some guy text me I wanted to sell him my dirty underwear. Bro, I swear to God.
Hey,
like my
though?
Sweaty, huh?
Did you though?
Told him to send him 500 and I'll send it, but he never sent it.
Damn.
He said, what was he offering?
You would have 500.
He was offering 500?
500, yeah.
Shit said a rack.
At least a rack, because he's going to come back.
Really, low-key, what you should have done was, like, bro, just go get some new pair. And he's just like, put some water on the holes, like,
fuck it. You gotta buy another pair. You can buy three more with the motherfucker. Yeah.
Look at a clean pair, piss on them, and then he sends it to me.
Piss on them?
Or you can just go at the gym?
Or you can just
It was like a unknown messenger type shit. But it's probably fake, but yeah. But I had I don't know who the fuck it was, but some Instagram, bro, for like probably a whole year straight, like, posting, like, I will post and she'll slit up or she, them, I don't know.
They
probably trans, fuck. But the dude would like fucking slide up every time, like, getting like gay shit, like, I wanna fuck you and stuff like
what
that.
What the freak?
Swear,
and
bro.
You didn't block him.
I didn't block him. Like, if I blocked him, I would be like a pussy and I didn't wanna.
Hey, I'm my number one supporter.
I was sending like Fortnite memes and shit.
He's fucking loving them.
Hell.
You ever had a stalker?
No.
I don't think that was a stalker. I think it was just being weird.
Or an admirer?
You've had the same one.
What do you mean?
You can bleep the name. That dude named.
What the fuck are you talking about, bro?
Bro,
that dude was gay.
No, he was not an admirer.
He used to slide up on my shit and call me like cute and this and that. And at one point, it wasn't like that. It was just kind of like he would slide up and say like, "Hey, like, and we should hang out one day, this and that." Like,
so it's like that.
So, and I never thought, it's because we used to go to school together, and I never thought anything of it. I just thought he was a little fam, but I thought he was straight, you know, I thought he liked women and all that. No, I just should have took the signs and thought,
Remember the one?
Oh, shit.
Do you know him?
Yeah, we all.
Bro, tell me you saw the video, right?
He showed it to me at work. He was like sticking to
the
butt?
Yes. I was eating Taco Bell at the parking lot, and then the fucking account liked one of my tweets, but like from like. Dude, yes, bro. They like one of my tweets and shit, like a picture. That was like from like years ago. No, and I clicked on it. Two videos of the same guy fingering his butt. And I was friends with him. And then I blocked him. Because fuck that shit.
Yep.
Motherfucker would try to dab me up. I'd be like, no.
Bro.
Which hand did you use,
bro? What's up, bro?
But like the guy had his legs like. All the way up, like, dude, like, all the way, yeah, type, yeah.
I don't even
want
to imagine type shit. I ain't even that flexible.
Imagínate? You look away. Top 5 wrestlers all time.
Five
dude,
wrestlers?
How the fuck do you do that?
What did you just
Chris Benoit, nah, fucking with you.
Backstory, Chris Benoit.
Supposedly,
allegedly, killed
his wife.
His son. And then himself.
Is it the one that, like, choked him?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I heard about that.
But it's crazy because in the storyline at the time that they were doing with WWE, the main, like, Vince McMahon, like, the chairman, whatever, he was part of the storylines back then a lot. And he had been killed off, supposedly, like, blown up in a limo, literally the week before this happened. And then the next week, he comes out on TV and he's like, we know that this and this and this. Basically admits that it's, like, fake when they never really do that, but not, like, in right words, you know? And then he's like passing of whatever, whatever. They had a whole memorial thing.
They didn't know at the time, right, what happened.
But supposedly, there's like a big thing supposedly saying that the scandal was, like, supposedly it's a scandal, like, that there's a lot of different things that are saying that he didn't do it.
Like, the wife he had, like, an ex-husband, like, she cheated on, like she cheated on him.
There motives, that sometimes stuff that happened didn't add up, like, supposedly, like, because it happened Sunday, he didn't show up for a pay-per-view, like, and it wasn't like him to ever do that, he didn't show up at all. And supposedly at that event, people were already saying that he had killed someone, or that he had killed whatever. There was already people saying it, supposedly. Like, sources that came out and said that there was talk of that before it even, like, was out there. Before anybody had stumbled upon the body, supposedly.
Dangle your mic.
So,
have you seen this current son right now? Like,
oh, yeah, his current son
exactly
right now.
Exactly like him, bro.
They look just alike. But they tried to erase him from, like, WWE, like, everywhere, like, they don't mention him. They don't mention him. They don't nothing. Like, nothing.
But, like, so, you remember, what's his name? Fuck. Owen Hart, when he fell? From, wrestler, like, fell from, like, I don't know how feet, but he fell straight to the ring and died. Mm-hmm.
Live,
yeah. They said they weren't recording, but I feel like...
He was on a pay-per-view.
It's a pay-per-view, yeah.
Fucking passed away on TV. She was crazy. Hella lawsuit. Nah, I'm playing.
But what is your wrestlers?
Sure. You first.
Fuck. Top five all time? Undertaker, Stone Cold, John Cena. Eddie Guerrero. And I don't know. DX.
Now you can use both of them.
DX.
Type shit. I'll do the same thing. I use DX, and then I'm gonna do all top, like, no specific order. Jeff Hardy, John Cena, Randy, and then DX. CM Punk probably.
See, if I forgot about CM Punk, god damn it, about CM Punk.
Oh yeah, when I first started watching, he was like doing that whole like I'm leaving the company. Yeah. Shit. That's when I first started watching.
That one's, wait, who's that?
So basically,
this one with the tattoo right here.
Yeah, yep. A bunch of tattoos. Cody Rhodes. That's the guy that just bought.
That's what I'm talking about. All right,
this guy, CM Punk, he barely came back, and in 2011, he was doing this big old story where like he hated, like he was basically saying like
telling the truth,
shit, like but like unpopular opinions that were true, and he was saying. He was like, John Cena has it made. They hand him everything, this and this and that. Like, he claims he's, like, some, like, underdog guy, like, a little guy. But he's become, like, the guy that just squashes everybody and puts himself first and all that bullshit. And he's, like, he ends up getting, like, so much traction that he's about to get a title match. And they're trying to get him to resign. And he won't resign. And he ends up about to resign because his contract expires the, like, 4 hours or 3 hours after his match is over.
Mm-hmm.
So if he wins, he takes the belt with him, and it basically like knocks like the prestigeness out of the title, you know, and it makes the WWE look bad, obviously, like their main guy, they're supposed to be their main guys walking out. So he ends up fucking winning and then walking out, and then he ends up coming back, and then he beats John Cena again, and then yeah, he just becomes like this badass wrestler, and yeah.
Oh yeah.
Type shit.
Damn. So is this a thing for people to leave and come back and leave again and come back? It sounds like people fucking leave and then they have to come back.
Sometimes it's crazy because sometimes it'll be worked into the story and sometimes it's like real life shit, like they actually leave to another company or like they real shit just don't want to continue their contract because a lot of motherfuckers get unhappy like with what they're used. They feel like they're supposed to be in a higher position. And then they leave.
Yeah.
But I mean, I guess that's anywhere in any sport, really.
Who's winning the Copa America? Argentina, the cheaters.
Bro.
Mexico.
Fucking oh, Mexico. Yeah. Got
fuck. Fucking. You saw the game yesterday?
No me fue nada, wey. So many fucking shots.
I got a bottle opener. You want it?
Oh, really?
Damn, my bad.
So, bro, my mouth is so fucking dry.
Yeah.
I gotta wait till Monday to drink one.
Monday turn 21.
You're barely turning 21? What?
You've been 21 for like 5 years.
I've been 21
since fucking you're at Walmart.
When did I get this?
Who's the first
one? Since 21 since he graduated.
No cap, 21 since then.
That still blows my mind. And it's crazy because you're the one that had said this, and it always plays in my mind whenever you were like, nigga, you were 17 in fucking After Hours Club getting fucked, you know? Like, and I was just like, damn, society ain't shit.
At all, bro. That's what's scary, nigga.
And it's like, whenever we're young like that, that's what we look for. Like,
oh, I can't wait to be 21 and shit like that.
You find what you look for.
It's a flex. No, but I'm saying it's a flex whenever you're younger. Low key.
Like, it's a flex when you're young as fuck.
Because sometimes this didn't always work for me, especially not here, because more people know, like, oh, that's him and he's not 21, you know? Like,
bro, I remember getting the bricks, like, fucking 18.
You still have the fucking.
The first time I went, no, not even, bro.
You can get
it. I had the fucking over 21 wristband.
How the fuck?
I'll wear that bitch to Walmart.
At least not give a fuck, bro. Over 21 wristband.
You used to fix that whole, like, yeah.
There's a bricks on me, nigga. I broke the whole story.
Is it weird seeing people from like high school you went to like now?
Sometimes. Yeah. Especially when they have two kids.
Fuck.
No, Dave, no hate towards having kids. I'm just saying, like,
it's a big mind-blowing thing. I don't even speak to the people I used to go to school. It's just like, we never spoke.
Some people I did speak to, though, I'll see and I'll be like, well, you're not talking to me. I guess I'm not talking to me.
Sometimes I don't even like saying hi to people.
I don't either.
I see them from afar, I'm like...
I go ahead and turn around.
I'm trying to say hello.
Yeah.
There's some people I do go out of my way with to say, what's up? Oh my gosh, I ain't seen that motherfucker in a while. What's up, bro?
There's some specific people.
There's some people like, yo, my like, oh yeah, but...
Hell, nigga, this is a month after I graduated high school,
10/31.
18 as fuck.
That was a month. I gotta post that at 10/31. I'm trying to dip at 11.
You gotta be home by 12.
The next fucking snap.
Damn, I didn't even go to that time.
That's oh my gosh. Where the fuck is this at?
Is it Bricks?
Yep.
They went even without me this time, you see?
I had a rope chain.
I can't believe it.
You got a big face.
Is that the rope chain that you used to have that letter pendant on? Type shit.
My nigga got a Hall of Fame jersey at Bricks.
Hernandez?
You got what?
Hall of Fame jersey.
You got
fucking legend.
A lot of those dogs or what?
How are those hot dogs? Are they good?
Them
amazing. Let me try them.
They haven't tried them.
Can we try Lalo's hot dogs?
I want the fucking macaroni is fucking amazing.
Really?
You haven't
tried that shit.
When?
I don't fucking know. I just had them.
Them was fire.
I think I had before DR. I think it was before DR.
They might be on DoorDash now.
Oh shit.
For real?
But it's only like Friday, Saturday.
It's open right now, isn't it?
También Joey's.
Enough said.
No, it's not.
Shit.
No? Teodoras, fuck it.
Teodoras, no. Not fuck it.
Shit. Well, on that note, guys, we're going to end up the podcast.
I was playing.
Yeah,
me too.
Bro, I was hoping. My girl's dad installed some unit, right? And on the back, it had a, you know, like it'll have on the back, like of anything that has like a motor, really, it'll have like that metal that's like turned a certain angle, like for ventilation purposes, I guess. I like grabbed to pick it up, like on the grate, like, and I pressed against it. And then as soon as I felt my fingers start cutting, I was like, what the fuck? I looked up, fucking blood all over my hand. But I'm surprised I ain't getting it on my shirt. But yeah, you can see how the grate is still.
Oh, yeah.
My finger. Oh shit, I didn't mean to flick you off with my
phone. That shit. The thing.
Shit, well, guys.
Hey, how do y'all. Okay, before we end the podcast, how do y'all look at y'all nails? Try to look at some.
Like this?
You're gay!
You're gay!
You're
gay!
You're gay! You're gay!
Bro, I was told if you look at your nails like this, you're gay. So, like, I was
I look like this!
I look like this!
I was
gay too!
So then my girlfriend, she asked me, she's like, how do you look at your nails? And I like
one at a time.
Like this, or like this, or. And then she asked her dad, you like this? He's like, you're looking like that! Oh, he's fucking gay!
Oh, like, bro, what the fuck?
You're gay.
Motherfucker wanted to set us up.
You're good.
You're gay.
Nah, I just be like, look at him.
That's kind of manly.
Yeah,
He's kind of manly.
Why? Because of his fingers?
It's because he's not going like this. He's going like this.
Well, like now he's doing it because everybody's looking at his
ass.
It's
like he's about to grip some fucking wood or something.
But yeah, some fucking wood.
Or some 2x4. Or, or some fucking big-ass piano.
Damn, you about to fucking tighten the strap with those hands? Shit.
Not tight, I don't know.
Damn, you look like you could lift and lower.
Put a roller coaster.
Car accident.
We almost died.
No pasa nada,
we weren't even going more than 50.
We weren't even going more than fucking 41.
Side to side, swaying and shit, almost hitting cars and shit.
Oh, we were swinging in the
yard. Yeah, we were swinging in the yard.
We got a double way while riding the go karts or whatever the fuck.
What did he say? Was it swinging?
No, zigzag.
No zigzag. No zigzag.
He said, no zigzagging.
You have two options. We stoppy that, or we go back to the lobby. I said, okay, stoppy that.
Fucking everything's like, hang. The whole, everybody's waiting in a line. Wait.
There's like fucking 40 people.
There's like 40 people in carts waiting all in line. They stop, like, because what they'll do is they'll have people like driving in between them that work for them, and then they'll have like walkie talkies. Bro, all we fucking see is we're coming around the corner having fucking so much fun. Like, I passed him, he passed me. We're fucking zigzagging.
It was me, my dad, my brother, and these two niggas, bro. They fucking all on the road. No, we're supposed to be going in a straight line.
Some Texas boys.
Nigga, he'll literally stop by everybody. Hey, no zigzagging. We go back to the office. No refund. I'm sorry, we can't. Nigga.
Bro,
go and say one by one by one.
He told us, we're gonna, we two options. We're gonna stop that or we go.
No, I'm like, zigzagging.
I said, I looked at all in. All right. I just went back. I just looked back like this. But bro, it's funny.
I don't know why. Like, my intrusive thoughts were telling me as soon as we started back to...
I wanted to so bad.
That was my intrusive thought. But I know.
I'm like, damn, ya me regañaron.
But it's funny because, like, they'll all, like, you'll be in a line. Like, you'll come around a corner and everybody's parked on the side already. So you park right behind the person in front of you. And then you just hear, zoom, zoom. And it's all the guys that are working. And then the big one comes. And then he gets off. Yeah, he gets off. And he comes and talks to us. And we're like, fuck. Like, talks to him first. The and general he's behind me. And he's like, don't do that. We're not doing that. I'm like, fuck. Wait, luego. We get to the stop because we kept driving. And then there's a stop where you go to like a lagoon. You go down. Everybody gets off. They turn off the fucking cart. You take your helmet off and everything. He fucking stops everybody. He's like, okay. No zigzagging. He tells everybody all over again. We're all just fucking like looking at him, like not trying to laugh and shit. And then yo, we didn't zigzag no more. And then they told us to fill out like a survey, like of our experience. And then we were like,
to love the zigzag.
He said, sorry for the swinging is what hit the motherfucker put.
Sorry for swinging.
And shit was funny as fuck.
I'm gonna let him know so when he looks it up, he's gonna see swingers on the damn
swinging
Cadillac.
You know, there's a bartender way, cleanest fade I've ever seen. Way,
bro. Nigga hairline, bro.
The crispy. What
the fuck are you talking about,
bro? The nigga at the bar, we were like, that nigga edge up is crispy as fuck.
Zipper, was it 24/7 one?
Zipper up when you're done, bro.
Zipper up when you're done, bitch.
Bro, I'm over here already like drunk as fuck.
Make sure you wipe your mouth. Make sure you wipe your mouth after.
Bro, I'm over the freaking. The bar just standing like this, all freaking drunk, and I look at him and I'm like, hey, I'm like. Me líder. And then he fucking turns around. And I'm like, tu corte de pelo? And then like, the whole time, he's like, all smug, fucking, just putting cups and shit. And then he goes. Motherfucker shows his whole fade. It was crazy because it was, like, such a small area. Because his fade was, like, really, really high. And it was, like, right here. But it faded and blended in such a small area. Way,
I know
like,
what y'all talking about. That nigga's really fade.
Motherfucker looked like he could have been bro. Romeo Santos 10 years ago.
That shit ain't gonna lie, bro. No dick run, bro. That nigga should
have played. No glazing. No glazing.
Nigga, that whole not recorded. Yours not.
All right, everybody. With that being said, we're going to end the TYF podcast. Thanks for tuning in. It
with
was
a bang.
Fun. We're going to have more of Lalo coming in the future. It's fun always having you on.
Thank you. Thank
you know I have a dog named Lalo?
No. Nigga, that's not a fucking compliment.
He got stung on the lip.
Today?
Yeah, I got home. This whole shit right here on the side.
What kind of dog is it? Chihuahua?
Nah. It's a chow and a pit bull mix. That look cute. That look cute.
It is also his TikTok profile picture, so.
Yeah, so you're here to find it.
Anybody else have any final words, Lalo? Anything you want to share before we end it off?
No.
Don't be gay and stay fat.
You see, everybody? Well, thanks for coming today.
That is wrong, it could be gay.
And remember,
it's easier to turn $1 into $2 and turn $100 into $200. TYF, we're signing out.
We're signing out, bitch.